Everything around us is getting smarter. Our phones, our cars, our homes, and now even our clothes. Joining us today to talk about the growing smart clothing market is Janet Liriano. She's the CEO of smart fabric company Loomia. How's it going, Janet?
It's going well. I'm here in New York and glad that we beat the rain. So can't complain too much.
Great. Well, thanks so much for joining us. And first, tell our audience a little bit about Loomia's role in the smart clothing space. So you're working with existing clothing brands to add the special material to garments, right?
That's right. And for those of you that don't know, Loomia Technologies has been around for about 4 years. Originally, we were called Create It. Maddie Maxey, founder of Loomia, started the company about 4 years ago to really solve integrating technology into fabrics. At first, we were working with conductive inks, and over the years, we invented and developed our technology, which is called the Loomia Electronic Layer, and that's basically a fabric circuit board. Not too different from a printed circuit board, except ours can be washed, dried, and sewn into your garments. So that's what we do.
Okay, great. And so what are the applications for this type of clothing that can be created from this smart layer, other than heating and color changing, I've heard?
Sure. So the four different applications, and you mentioned color changing, I guess that's the fifth, that we can create with our textile circuit is heating. So we can pattern a resistive heating element. And for those that may be unfamiliar with that phrase, a resistive heating element is a tight either coil or set of waves that are patterned onto the material. And when you pump power through it using a battery pack, it'll heat the fabric. Lighting, we print custom LEDs directly to the textile and route power through the fabric itself to provide lighting. Applications for that are safety primarily, or for convenience, like illuminating the interior of a backpack or a purse. I think we've all been in that situation where you're behind in the backseat of a cab looking for your keys, and it would be helpful if there was a light in there. Sensing is the third application. Sensing, when you think of, you know, creating surfaces to control other functions, sensing pressure, sensing temperature and speed, and finally data. We create a small 1-inch by 1.5-inch tag that can measure product use, exposure to wash, and exposure to environmental conditions over time. We're building a companion app that can take the data from that garment and allow users to trade that as well. So those are the four different applications, and color changing is one of the more fun ones.
All right. Well, great. Yeah. I mean, everything is so data centric now. So that's incredible that that's even being brought to our clothing now. And, you know, clearly we're still in the early stages of the market here for these types of products. So what would you say are the biggest barriers to mass adoption? Are you finding that you're needing to convince brands more or consumers more?
I think in the early days of wearables, we really saw an interesting intersection where first there wasn't a common language. Folks were very concerned about finding components that were waterproof, but what you needed was something that was washable, because the environment of a washing machine is very different than passive water flowing over a component. So in those early days, you found big bulky sensors, large battery packs sort of Frankensteined onto goods. And I think that creates a user adoption challenge, because right now we put on our jacket or our shoes and we're not expected to take out a cord and remember to charge it at the end of the night. But with advancements in e-textiles, and to give us some credit, the work that Loomia has been doing, we're much closer to being able to create use cases that are more seamlessly integrated into these garments. In terms of, you know, what's needed to really bring this to the market, brands are aware that smart products are coming. And I think it's a matter of finding the technology that can scale with existing manufacturing processes that doesn't require a seamstress to become an electrical engineer. And that's a lot of the work that we've sought to do with our core technology.
Yeah. And can you expand on that a little bit about how adding this layer impacts the manufacturing process?
Sure. So as I mentioned, it's a fabric, so it can be sewn, it can be heat pressed in, and the circuit is self-contained. So what that means is we deliver a pre-cut, pre-patterned element that a seamstress can sew in like she would sew in any lining, or treat it like trim like any other fabric. So there's no need to really understand how to create a circuit, because the textile is already operational and functional in the shape that it's in. So a lot of the early work that we spent doing about 3 years ago, really researching the challenges that were in the space, we really came across the same common problems. Wires are not very comfortable and they're very difficult to scale. Soldering is not something that scales very easily in an apparel manufacturing facility, and it's not washable either or very robust. So we sought to solve those challenges by creating a self-contained circuit in a textile that when you pass that off to your bulk manufacturer, they're not doing anything too different than what they do for any of the other fabrics that roll through the facility.
And you mentioned the data aspect of this, which is very key. And there's a commerce component to that as well that you guys are involved with, right?
That's right. So first, I think it's really important to discuss two words that are often interchanged, privacy and transparency. So, and also control. I guess all of these words are very buzzy, in particular with what's going on with Facebook and Cambridge Analytica. As I mentioned, we have this data tag that can gather data that's very different than streaming or tracking or reporting back data without user control. So I'll explain what the technology is in the tag and then the commerce marketplace that goes into it. So the tag itself is very similar to a tape recorder. You choose when to turn it on, and it will record motion and environmental data directly to this small tag. If you stop recording, it's not going to go anywhere unless you choose to play back and share it with whoever would like to hear what your garment was doing in a day. So the way that we do that is by having a data storage capability on the tag, and it's offloaded with NFC. For those that don't know, NFC is near field communication chips. So that requires a receiver and a transmitter, and only at that point in time is the data removed from the garment and then is now on a mobile application. From that mobile application, the user can choose to sell this data with different brands and market researchers or anybody that would be interested in receiving this garment feedback. And we are building a reward and incentive structure around that. So that mobile app will be live this summer. And it's all meant to really put power, control, and transparency back in the user's hands while providing a lot of critical missing data to the apparel and soft goods industry.
That's very fascinating where we could see that headed in the next few years. So talking about R&D quickly before we go here, could we see other materials from Loomia down the road? You know, I'm thinking like a cotton t-shirt or, you know, a wool blanket. Are there going to be other types of materials that the technology can be seamlessly woven into everyday wear type clothing?
I appreciate that question, and I'll be sure to send you some updated product photos and videos of what's coming to market this year. In the fall, consumers will be able to purchase a Loomia-enabled outerwear garment, and can't quite announce the brand just now, but hopefully by the end of the week, we can share that update with you. And if you could imagine walking outside wearing a blazer not too different than the one I'm wearing, and if there were sensors inside that blazer that could tell that it was a little chilly to trigger that resistive heating in the lining, that's one of the applications that we're excited about bringing to market. They can be very easily integrated into shoes. You mentioned a blanket. We're very interested in the medical and particularly the elder care space as well, where sensing and comfort is really important. So we're excited to put our materials into a wide variety of soft good products.
All right, well, great. And we're looking forward to the update from you guys. So thanks for keeping us up to date on all of that. And thank you for taking the time to speak with us.
My absolute pleasure. Thanks for having me on.
Great. So for more on the smart clothing market and other emerging technologies impacting the economy, make sure to check out investors.com. For Investors Business Daily, I'm Alyssa Corum.